I started cycling at the age of 34. Age shouldn't be the bar for any sports activity or any adventure activity which you take. It doesn't matter your gender or you're married or you're not. The world record don't take into consideration whether you are a female or male or what age you are doing it.
Kabhi doctor to kabhi dancer. Kabhi apni cycle le chalu main pahadon ke paar. Koi mushkil na rok sake mujhe kabhi. है दम तो पेश कर कोई भी नई चुनौती मेरे यार।
I'm Dr. Neha Tikam. I'm born and brought up in Pune. I've done my master's in homeopathy. I'm also a Visharad in Bharatnatyam. I'm a yoga teacher at TeraFit where we all work out. And I'm also acupuncture therapist. I've done a lot of ultra-endurance cycling races. So I'm an ultra-endurance cyclist. At the age of 14, my mother introduced me into Indian classical dance, that is Bharatnatyam. Any Indian classical form, as you all know, you learn how to have patience in your life, you know perseverance, you know, dedication and that kind of a thing. Like the one adab in Bharatnatyam, you do it for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, and then you get a chance to actually perform on a song. I used to take Bharatnatyam dance classes. I had almost 50 students. After like 15, 20 years of those dance classes, it started becoming monotonous for me and I thought of taking a break from dance. I was working out in the gym that time. My coach, who is he's also my coach for my cycling, Siddharth Gadekar. He was taking spinning batches that time. Then I got to know that he was training for one race from Pune to Goa. And that time he gave all the gym members one challenge that let's do one outdoor ride. Let's ride from Pune to Mahabaleshwar. So it is almost 110 kilometers ride. I didn't have cycle that time. So I just went to a bicycle shop. I got one cycle on the rent and I thought, why not take it the challenge and let's do this. He trained us for a month around Pune and I rode that 110 kilometers non-stop, like a few chai stops and all. And I was very happy and I enjoyed that ride very much. And then I sat with him, I discussed that can I take cycling as a sport and can I train with you, and that how the journey started. Your childhood as a girl child, you are always, you know, been taught that don't go alone, don't night walk alone is risky for you, don't ride alone, don't go for cycling alone, or even for hikes or any adventure sports. It has been taught to us from the childhood that it is scary or risk is involved, you know. But then why not give it a chance? You always fall if you go on a hike. You might break your bike and you might land into a situation which are you are not used to that. But then when you are alone and when you solve those problems on your own, you get that confidence, you know, you feel empowering after you accomplish that goal. Even cycling in India, you can say it's a male dominating sport. Very few female riders which I know who are into ultra endurance cycling, where you have to ride hundreds of kilometers, you are alone or you're on the street. So it is obviously risk is involved, you are alone that time. But then you have to fight your thing and you come over. So Guinness recognizes the world record as the fastest distance traveled on cycle from point A to point B. In my case, it was from Leh to Manali. Considering its challenging terrain, the altitude and unpredictable weather, I started my cycling journey, the world record attempt on 15th of August at 7 o'clock from Leh main gate. Border Road Organization officers were there to flag off. I started at 7. The weather was really nice. When I crossed 50 kilometers and the very first highest climb on the entire route was Taglangla. On the just base of it, I started feeling discomfort in my stomach and sort of a bloated feeling, and it was not going at all. I was feeling very uncomfortable because I had to climb almost 5,300 meters of elevation gain. So that was the highest pass which I had to pass in the very first day of my ride. And even the weather got very much it started raining, it started kind of a snowfall on the top, and the temperatures got very low. And I had one MTB, that is mountain bike, with me. So I rode that at night, and it was all the elevation gain at night. So that was very challenging for me. Previous record on this route was 55 hours. Considering my training, my coach gave me that target of 40 hours. So on the very first day, this all things were like, you know, unexpected. So I was behind almost by 6 hours. The second day of our attempt, there was a big landslide, or you know, the road sunk in the Manali. So a lot of things happened, but then at the end, when I was at the finish line with my crew, you know, it doesn't matter. It is all the happiness and positive things which you think of, all those good memories. Sports, I would say, it gives you that freedom, you know, that confidence, not just like, it teaches you patience, it teaches you that determination, and that helps you in your personal life as well. So it is empowering, it is about, you know, realizing yourself also. There is one research which I read about in women. As you get older, you become more stronger than men. So there are a lot of females winning the races, ultra endurance races, trail running, and even the cycling, you can say. Even there is world's most difficult race, that is SRMR, Silk Road Mountain Race. Even that was kind of, you know, one female. Age doesn't matter. It is about your mental strength. So I would really wholeheartedly would like to encourage all the females and girls around India or all around the world to take up all these adventurous sports, not just cycling, but go for hiking, go for trail runs, and all take all the adventurous sports, because it's just one life and you have to, you know, enjoy it to the fullest, and just don't think about all those insecurities or inhibitions coming your way. And if just dream, work on that, and you know, push yourself and enjoy that journey.